In April 1861, five companies answered Abraham Lincoln's call to arms for 75,000 volunteer troops. Two of those five companies, the National Light Infantry and the Washington Artillery, were organized in Schuylkill County and sent 236 men in response to the rebellion. After weeks of waiting, the first defenders were formally organized in the 25th Pennsylvania Volunteer Infantry. Nicholas Biddle was a 65-year-old African-American aide to the commanding officer of the Washington Artillerist, Captain James Rinn. As the first defenders marched through Baltimore, a member of the crowd threw a brick in Nicholas Biddle's direction, hitting him on the head. The wound started bleeding and Nicholas Biddle fell to the ground. He would have that scar for the rest of his life till the day he died in 1876 at the age of 82. He is believed to be the first casualty of the war. The 48th Volunteer Infantry was organized in late August and early September of 1861 in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania at Camp Curtin. Colonel James Nagle of Pottsville, Pennsylvania was given command of the regiment. A total of 850 officers and men were mustered into service. The 48th participated in over 53 battles and skirmishes over the course of the war. They got mustered out of service in Alexandria, Virginia in July 17, 1865. 11 officers and 155 enlisted men died in the battle, or were wounded, or were missing in action. Three officers and 142 men died of disease. The 50th Volunteer Infantry was organized in service September 25, 1861 at Camp Curtin in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Colonel Benjamin C. Christ of Minersville was given command of the regiment. The 50th Pennsylvania unit participated in over 53 battles and skirmishes over the course of the war. They were relieved of their duty in Georgetown, Washington, D.C. on July 30, 1865. Eight officers and 156 enlisted men were killed, or wounded, or missing in action. Also, four officers and 180 men died of disease. The 96th Volunteer Infantry Unit was organized at Camp Curtin, Harrisburg on August 23, 1861. Colonel Henry Cake was the commander of the regiment. The 96th participated in over 45 skirmishes throughout the war. September 22, 1864 was when the regiment's term of service was over. However, the company was not mustered out of service until October 21, 1865 in Hestonville, West Philadelphia. The fighting they did during the war either claimed the lives of or wounded or went missing in action of six officers and 126 men. One officer and 86 men died of disease during the war. The 129th Volunteer Infantry was brought into service on August 15, 1862 at Camp Curtin. The leading officer was Jacob Frick of Schuylkill County. The 129th Infantry Unit was only involved in the war for 9 months from August 15, 1862 till May 18, 1863. During their service, the regiment lost three officers and 37 enlisted men, killed and mortally wounded, and one officer and 42 enlisted men by disease, for a total of 83 men. The 7th Cavalry was organized at Camp Cameron in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania in 1861 for a 2-year term of service. George C. Beinkoop was given command of the regiment. The 7th Cavalry unit participated in over 100 battles and skirmishes over the course of the war. The 7th was mustered out of service in Macon, Georgia, August 13, 1865. During the war, 8 officers and 94 enlisted men were killed or wounded or went missing in action. 5 officers and 85 enlisted men died of disease. Second Battle of Bull Run from August 28th, 29th, and 30th, 1862 was where the Pennsylvania 48th Infantry Unit really did its first fighting. The 48th marched along the battlefield aside of the 6th Infantry Unit from New Hampshire. The 48th had the front left and rear left of the battlefield covered during fighting. Fighting the 50th did was a lot bloodier than what the 48th did. They fought alongside of Schur's division of Sigel's corps. They occupied the right wing of the army as they attacked. During the Battle of Antietam, September 17, 1862, the 48th did a lot of fighting. This fighting took place alongside of the 50th Pennsylvania Infantry Unit. The two units fought to keep control of the hills immediately beyond Burnside Bridge and Sharpsburg. It was the bloodiest battle during the whole American Civil War. During the start of the battle, the 50th Pennsylvania Infantry, along with the 28th Massachusetts Infantry, were sent to give support to Ira Harris's cavalry. Soon after the 50th got new orders and charged ahead, they started advancing the Union lines until they came under heavy fire from the Confederate Army. The 50th did hold the position till the Confederates were forced to retreat. Battle of Fredericksburg, December 11th through the 15th, 1862, where the 48th was held in reserve till 2 in the afternoon. They did not see real fighting the first part of the day. When it got its orders to start engaging in the battle, they set up on the hills around Fredericksburg. Shortly after noon of the 13th of December, the 129th Division started proceeding through the town to a position in full view of the battlefield, awaiting the orders to enter the fight. The 129th covered the left front side of a hopeless and fruitless charge, not being able to break the impenetrable position that the enemy held. Battle of Stones River started in Nashville, Tennessee and ended in Stones River. It was a march by the two armies' cavalry, and fighting took place during the whole march, but only 2 men from the Pennsylvania 7th Cavalry Division lost their lives. The Union Army came away with a victory at Stones River. Battle of Chancellorsville, April 30th through May 6th, 1863, the 48th took the place of the 17th Vermont after the 17th Vermont had exhausted the ammunition. The 48th were placed on the crest of a hill overlooking an open field and a swamp with a creek running horizontally through it. As the fog disappeared, Confederate troops were seen in the swamp below. The 48th engaged in fighting, sustaining heavy losses. The Confederate Army won the Battle of Chancellorsville. On May 6th, the 50th started fighting. They were bringing up the back of the battlefield, and as they fought and marched, they were closely followed by the enemy's cavalry division. 96th arrived several hours late on the battlefield. By the time they got there, the fighting was over and they could see the aftermath of what had taken place hours before. The 96th reorganized and then held its part of the Union line. In the Battle of Wilderness, May 5th, 6th, and 7th of 1864, the 96th formally lined in the battlefield's extreme left, did a lot of fighting during the battle. After the battle, the Pennsylvania 96th Infantry Unit was described as the best infantry unit in the Keystone State. The 129th formed a line of battle and started a fire. Once the fire had been delivered with precision and accuracy, the commanding officer gave a retire command, but the 129th did not hear it. They saw that the right side of the line had retired, so they finally did before they got cut off from the rest of the army. As they did retire, they came under heavy fire from the enemy. The Battle of the Crater was on July 30th, 1864. The 48th spent most of the time along a line of fortified positions and trenches more than 20 miles long, stretching from Richmond to Petersburg. No fighting was really taking place because both armies had fortified positions. Henry Pleasant was the commander of the 48th Volunteers. He went to his commanding officer, General Burnside, and told him that they could dig a mine shaft under the Confederate line. The majority of the officers in the 48th were mine workers back home. Pleasant himself was a mine engineer. On June 25th, they began digging a tunnel. The high-ranking Union officers didn't think Pleasant's idea would work, so they did not really give him the materials he needed. They kept the mine shaft held up with wood and other things to support it. They had an airflow system so that there was always fresh air from the outside in the shaft. Once they had the shaft under enemy lines, they put 320 kegs of gunpowder approximately 20 feet under the Confederate Army. On July 30th, around 3:15 a.m., Henry Pleasant set the fuse on fire. The explosion does not happen, so two men of the 48th go in to see what happened. Henry Reese and Jacob Dally went in the tunnel to see what happened. They saw the fuse had burned out and set the fire. At 4:44 a.m. on July 30th, the explosion happened. After the explosion, Union troops went to fight, but it turned out that they had planned wrong and the crater just turned into a shooting gallery for the Confederates' troops. The idea Henry Pleasant had worked, but it turned into a victory for the Confederate Army. Gettysburg on July 1st through the 3rd, 1863, the 96th were not there for the start of the battle. They showed up on July 2nd. They marched 131 miles from Fredericksburg, Virginia to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. They held their position in front of the Little Round Top till the end of the battle. Charles P. Potts, lieutenant of the 151st PA Regiment, kept a short diary of his time at Gettysburg. Started the battle marching to Gettysburg from Emmitsburg. He then was caught by the rebels. He spent his time at Gettysburg as a prisoner of war. He spent time in five different prisons and would not be exchanged until until September 9, 1864. United States President Abraham Lincoln, March 1861 to April of 1865. He was assassinated April 15, 1865 in Ford's Theater in Washington, D.C. His assailants believed if he was dead, the South would rise again. His death was the last one in the bloody history of the Civil War.